has been your favorite voice or cameo that you've gotten to do? Do you like being behind the microphone?
I don't fancy myself an actor, but it's fun to do. I think the things I've enjoyed the most are when we've done like the live show here in Colorado Springs, and for some reason having that audience feedback is just fun to play off of. But the first role I ever did is probably the one I would least want people to recognize, because it's the voice of Jesus in the first Imagination Station series that I was totally corralled into. I was the new guy on the block, and you're like, hey, Dave, you go in and try it. I thought, well, this won't last very long. And the next thing I knew, I was like doing the part, so.
That's how they duped me into doing Glossman, so we're all part of the same club.
You think we would have learned or something from
that? Well, no, I did learn. That's how I duped you into doing Jesus. It was easy having had the same trick pulled on me.
Awesome. What was it like? It was, for me, hard to hear. Hard to listen to, because nobody likes, well, I don't say nobody likes their own voice, but, you know, I mean, if you're not a professional voiceover actor, it's kind of difficult to get past it, to be honest, which is why we don't do it an awful lot anymore. There are many, many more seasoned and professional actors than those of us that are sitting behind this desk right here. But so, yeah, it was awkward. What did I tell my kids? You know, I think I didn't tell them anything and hope that they would never listen to it and hear it and discover how terrible of an actor I was. How about you, Paul?
Well, I think it's very telling that when Dave is cornered into doing a voice, he plays Jesus. And when I'm cornered into playing a voice, I get to play Glossman. I do hate my voice and don't like to listen to myself at all. But I do my kids the favor of at least flagging the episodes that I'm in so they don't have to listen to me, because they have to listen to me all the time.